Hello everybody, welcome back to another episode of Resonant Rise. Today we'll be continuing part 2 of Botania. Now if you'll notice in episode 12 of my series on Resonant Rise, I did a step-by-step part 1, and that showed you how to do everything basic. We're ready to go on to the next level, part 2, and I'll put a link in annotation and in the description below. I'll lay a link down there as well. What we're going to do is some automation, and as you can see, I have some daisies making living rock or living wood and living stone, and there is an easier way to do it, and that's what I'd like to do today. I'm just going to grab one of these, and we'll be off to get ready to do some automation. One of the things that we'll need, I've been smelting some stone, we'll need to smelt a few of these down. This is more than what we need, because this makes 2 each, but that's fine, I can keep it in here. We're gonna need some plates from here, and this should be more than enough. If I can pull it up here, this is the timer we want from Project Red. So let's pull up some of the things that we have in here and put them in here, and so we'll need this, which is a redstone, a regular stone, and then the circuit plate below. And we'll need the top one as well. And these are just redstone combinations. So the other one is like this. And you need 3 of these. Very simple. So what are we missing here? We're missing this bottom one. We need one more of those. And there we are with our timer. We will also need some redstone, so I'll take a stack with me. Some regular stone. That would be here. Some stone bricks, and you'll see why in a second. A couple of block breakers. And the kind that I'll be using is by open blocks. I'm going to make 2 of these. So 1, 2. Let's make 2 block breakers. And then we need a couple of block placers. And again, we'll use open blocks. And there we are. We'll take a stack of wood with us. And these will be converted. I'll take oak. And of course, the daisy right here. So I think we're ready to go. I don't think there's anything else we need. So I'll meet you over there. Okay, I put a chest here so that we can organize our stuff, but this is so few things that I don't think we need to. The first thing we're going to do is to place our daisy where we want it. And then we'll take the wood and place it where it should go, as well as the stone. You'll take the placers and place them above them. And then take the stone bricks, and these are just for holding the redstone. It makes it clearer to see where the redstone is. Then take your block breakers and place them toward the blocks they will be breaking. You'll now take your redstone and come across all of the top. As well as down into another block. You don't really need this block, but it does make it look nice. You'll increase this to 1 minute. I'm sorry, 100 seconds. 102 is fine. As long as it's more than 1 minute, it should be okay. More is fine, less is not so fine. Everything is done. It's ready to go. All we need to do is just fill these with the items that we want to convert. So let's just put wood on this one and stone on this one. It doesn't really matter. When the next pulse comes, it'll send a signal first to the breaker, then to the placer. and I've tested this a while already and it seems to work just fine. The last thing we will need is a vacuum chest or a vacuum hopper. I choose a chest because I don't plan to do a whole slew of these. I don't need thousands of these. I just need a couple of stacks from each. So here we are in front of my ME system. I've sent some iron and pearls to be alloyed, as you can see, and what that makes is pulsating iron, this green ingot here. So if we go in here, pulsating iron, we can see some already smelted. We'll need to have these nuggets made, so we'll just make one stack of them. We are now making a vacuum chest, which is this one right here. You'll need to make one of these, and it needs those nuggets around one diamond. Now we can make the chest, and I'll meet you back. Okay, so now we need to place the vacuum chest before these things convert, and we will place it very close to where it should go. This is fine. It doesn't have to be that close, but just to conserve some space. And there you see that they are converted. And soon it will be transitioning. It looks like it needs another 10 seconds. I'll fast forward this. And there it is. The new ones were placed. The old ones have been sent into the chest, as you can see, and they will be collecting. All you need to do is to fill this up with loads and loads of stone, and this one with loads and loads of wood, and you should be good to fill up this chest. Now I do want to show you another way to do it. I didn't show you this before because in some mod packs you don't have Mechanism or the Digital Miner, so you won't be able to do it this way, but if you do have Resonant Rise or at least Mechanism installed, you should be able to use the Digital Miner for this. Go down to bedrock level somewhere, make a little room down there, and place a Digital Miner somewhere above or near the daisy with the living rock and living stone set up with just placers. All you need are the placers, not the breakers. Then you go into config and set a new filter. Go to the materials tab and place in each one. Living rock, hit save, and it's saved. A new filter, material, living wood, hit save, and there it is. Now if you back up to the main config location, you can see that you can set the radius here to something small from 0 to about 11, wherever your room is located, and you can save that and start. The drawback with this is that you'll need to feed it power. We have loads of power here, but I just did want to show you this setup, the block placer and breaker, because it requires no power. And it's probably easier for some people to use if you know redstone. Very simple setup. Otherwise, you can use the digital miner if you're willing to give it a lot of power. Alright guys, we're back at the starter base. I'm going to show you now something that you're going to need to build sooner or later. It's a helpful device. It's not something required. But definitely, you want to do this. You're going to have to use a mana pool, a live mana pool. In other words, you need to feed it mana regularly because it's going to need it. That's why I'm back here at the base. Now, this is called a jaded amaranthus, and instead of running around and mowing the lawn manually or running through the forest with your horn of the wild clearing out the area, you're going to need mystical flower petals in a lot of the Botania recipes. For that reason, what we need to do is to automate the growing of these flowers so that you don't have to spend a whole lot of time out there picking flowers from the field. And so that's what we're going to be building today. It's a jaded amaranthus. Let's take a look at it. Jaded amaranthus. That's this guy here. You can make it in a blood altar. We'll be doing the petal apothecary. There's no other recipe for it in Resonant Rise 3. So this is what we'll be doing. So I want to show you what one looks like. This is a jaded amaranthus. If I place it down near a mana pool, you'll start seeing flowers grow. And there's one over there, there's one over here. You'll notice that they're only mystical type flowers. So this is a very important device, very good device to have, because in that short space of time, I've collected all these flowers. So then for this recipe, what we'll need is a fishing rod, sugar cane, and bone meal with 3 mana ingots. We'll drop the living rock on top and close the deal. And this will give us a rune of water. And now the next item we need is a rune of fire, which is made from 3 mana steel, a nether wart, gunpowder, and nether brick, a single nether brick. Let's close this deal. And that gives us a rune of fire. Our last item requires the rune of water and rune of fire, 1 wheat, and 3 saplings of any kind. Any vanilla sapling is what I would recommend. Let's close this deal and smack it over there. And now we have a rune of the spring. Well, for the next part of this recipe, we're going to need this redstone root, some purple dye, and a couple of green petals of different shades. So this one is the regular green petal, and this is the lime green petal. And that'll make our jaded amaranthus in a petal apothecary. So let's get to it. The way to make the redstone root is to combine a redstone with a grass in any pattern shape. It doesn't matter. We'll grab that, and then we'll go out, and it's nighttime. Okay, I brought up the daytime, and let's get to it. We're going to need to go to the mana pool and drop 2 purple petals to make the mana petal, as opposed to the regular petal. And now we can drop it into our petal apothecary. We'll need a bucket and drop in some water from there into here. Drop in the 2 mana petals, a regular purple, lime green, and regular green. Drop in the redstone root, and we need some seed. So let's see. I don't see any seed, so we'll just grab some of this. Okay, the last thing we need is the rune of the spring. And then we can drop our seeds in. And there we are, jaded amaranthus. Now, what we're going to do, instead of planting it just anywhere, we're going to plan this out. We need 4 spaces away from the mana pool. Because this jaded amaranthus will start planting flowers 4 spaces away from it. So 1, 2, 3, and 4. 1, 2, 3, and 4 over here. All around. The next thing we'll do is get a autonomous activator. Now recently, I don't know if there's a change with it. If there's a way to change it. But I tried a couple of times and it looks like the autonomous activator now requires power. I don't know if there's any way around that. But let's go ahead, go outside. And we need to place this. Well, let's see. What I want to do is put 4 vacuum hoppers. It can pick up 3 spaces away. But if we count it, it'll go down 1 and across 2 and 3. So it'll stop here. It won't pick up this 4th line. If we were on the same line as the flowers, then it would go 1, 2, 3, and 4. It would outstretch all the way out here. So for that reason, we're going to need to plant these vacuum hoppers around. So it'll be around as jaded amaranth. Here's 1. Here's another. Yep. We're doing it around the jaded amaranth. Problem is, I don't have a flower here yet. So what we can do is just grab a couple of these and plant them manually. We can put it right next to it, right here. And we'll grab another and put it, oh, I didn't grab that. Let's put it right here. So now the, yep, it will go right here. And the other is right here. So there's a jaded amaranth. And it's surrounded by vacuum hoppers. And this should be close enough for it to pick up all edges, even out here. So let's check it out. We need to set the items. Let's get rid of all of this by pressing O. We need to set the item import to the bottom. So, if we grab it and rotate it, we can access the bottom. And you see the blue there? Well, I just realized, actually, I'm working it up. So I do need it, not on the bottom, but instead on the top. So it'll be like that. Yeah, let's do it all for all of them now. Okay, all of them have their nozzles facing upward now that I set it. Now we'll connect some item conduit to them. Let's shift as we place them. And then connect them all together. And there it is. Now we'll extract without redstone signal on all of them. And then they will be imported into our Tesseract so that it goes into my ME system. There's a number of ways you can do this. You can use Java barrels instead, as a lot of people do. It doesn't really matter. So we'll have to set this to insert, and there it is. And now this has got to be set to item sending, power receiving. Where's the power going to go? Well, to the autonomous activator. And so we'll place this right in the middle. And this horn of the wild that we will be placing inside of here can reach really far. I don't know exactly how far. I think it's 16 blocks. Correct me if I'm wrong. It doesn't really matter. I do know that it can definitely reach all of this. And that's all we need. So if we put our horn of the wild in, I guess I left it in here. And we place it inside the autonomous activator. We'll need to set it so that it only selects one location. And it'll be right side. You'll notice that all of them get picked up by me because I forgot to take my magnetization off. Okay, so it's still planting flowers, as you can see. And as soon as they're planted, the Horn of the Wild picks it up. The vacuum hoppers suck it in. Send it to the Tesseract, and if we go inside to our ME system and we pull up Mystical Flower, you'll see that the numbers are increasing because as they're being planted, they're being sucked into our ME system. Perfect. So now we have all the Mystical Flowers we will ever need. I'll let this run for a little while. This was probably me, but as you can see, it's been running perfectly. And, yeah, so we'll be able to use these mystical flowers for the recipes that are required in Botania. And there are a lot of uses for it. You can shut this off after you get a good number, maybe a couple of thousand of the flowers, and then return it back on in a couple of years when you need more flowers. Well, I hope that this instructional tutorial is helpful to you. This is part two. Remember to check out part one. I'll leave a link in the description. I want to thank you for watching, and I'll catch you all next time.